Rollup Helper version 18.6 is out now. You can manually upgrade from inside the app under the Help and FAQ tab, or wait until the push upgrade coming soon. Today, I'm going to highlight some new features and improvements. 18.6 has two new features which I will show. The first has been highly requested, and we're excited to finally announce that you can create grandchild rollups in a single rollup setting for Premium Edition users only. And we've also added the ability to change the active status of multiple rollups by selecting them from the All Settings page and clicking Toggle Active. The first thing I'm going to show is how to set up a new grandchild rollup setting. For this example, let's count the number of products on opportunities and display the results on the account. Product will be the grandchild object, opportunity is the child, and account is the parent. First, click Create a New Rollup. In step one, first check the new Create Grandchild Rollup box. Then select account as the destination object as usual. Previously, I created a number field called Number of Products. I'm going to use this as the target field. Now we will choose both the child and grandchild object. First, select opportunity as the account child object. Then select opportunity product as the grandchild object. I'm choosing count for this rollup type. A new filter is optional for this example. Give it a name. And then save and run the rollup as we normally would. You can see it's simple to create a grandchild rollup setting with only a few additions. The Create Grandchild Rollup checkbox at the beginning, and then selecting the grandchild object in step three. That's it. Now I'm going to show you how to change the active status of multiple rollups at one time. Go to the All Rollups page, select the rollups you would like to change the activation status of. A new button will appear at the top that says Toggle Active. This will change all selected settings to go from active to inactive. And vice versa. You can even select a combination of activation statuses. We also have a lot of usability improvements. These first three I'll demonstrate as well. We've added a Rollup Helper menu to the All Settings page, which contains links to in-app pages such as Health Check, View Exceptions, Monitor Rollup Queue, Schedule Management, and the landing page. There's a new Health Check tab, and we've added the ability to start, delete, or change the running user for all Rollup Helper scheduled jobs. This is accessible via the Configure Rollup Jobs button on the All Settings page or Health Check page. And here is a quick overview of some of the latest usability improvements. On the All Settings page in the top right, we've added a Rollup Helper menu, which contains links to in-app pages to make it easier to get where you need to go to. And if you click the Configure Rollup Jobs button, you can now change the running user for all Rollup Helper scheduled jobs. This button is also on the Health Check page. Speaking of, there's now an added Health Check tab. This way, you can get to the page easily without having to go to the home page first. Finally, here are some other notable usability improvements. We've adjusted dates shown in the queue table to display the user's time zone instead of GMT. You can now clone a schedule's parent filter if it was from another schedule with the same target object. There's built-in foreign key triggers for task who relation and event who relation. We've added the ability to add multiple email addresses for the manual run completion email, and we've added the ability to have a scheduled rollup run only once. There's even more usability improvements and bug fixes we did not go over, so be sure to read the full Rollup Helper 18.6 release notes. Make sure you're subscribed to our release notes so you're notified right away when a new version is released. We hope you're excited about the new Grandchild rollups and other improvements we've made. If you have any other questions, you can always email our support team at support@passagetech.com or sign up for a one-on-one demo. All these links are provided in the description below. Leave a comment to let us know what you're most excited about or suggestions for new ideas. We love hearing from our users. Happy trailblazing!